So today is a webinar about using the BioSketch to create federal grant applications or as part of your federal grant application. Sherry Bailey is going to be presenting. And Sherry, so I'm going to go ahead and turn it over to you.
Thank you, Peter. Again, my name is Sherry, and I would like to thank you again for joining us. Our objective today is to create biographical sketches for NIH, NSF, and DOE. These are all United States federal grant applications. So before we really get started, let's have a quick poll. One of the things that we would like to know is which U.S. federal agencies that you will be using. Wow, it looks great. It looks like the majority of you will be using NIH. There's quite a few of you here who will be using NSF BioSketches, 13% other agencies, and some people haven't decided if they're going to submit or plan their submission. Great, so let's go ahead and jump right in. SciENcv and My Bibliography are part of a free profile service that is part of My NCBI, which is offered by the NIH, the National Institutes of Health. Benefits of a free NCBI account include professional profile tools and other great features to use with NCBI services. We will be providing links at the end of our presentation if you would like to learn more. But today our focus is My Bibliography for BioSketch creation. So what exactly is SciENcv? SciENcv allows you to document your education, employment, research activities, and incorporate your publications, your honors, your grants, research, as well as other professional contributions. A few benefits include the ability to leverage data from existing systems that you may already be using, like ORCiD, reduce administrative burden by creating a document once and then copying and editing that information for multiple grant applications, and taking comfort in knowing that the documents will appear to the government standards. When you create a BioSketch, you have three options: from scratch, duplicating an existing document and modifying, or using an external source like ORCiD to import citations and education. My Bibliography is a reference tool that helps you save your citations from PubMed. If you do not have citations in PubMed, don't worry. You can manually upload an RIS file, create it by your citation manager, and enter the citation information using the built-in template. An additional benefit of using My Bibliography is that you can generate a public URL to share your bibliography with others. Now that we have a general understanding of the tools used to create a BioSketch, let's briefly touch on how to create an account to access SciENcv. There are two ways. NSF users, you may want to directly go and Google SciENcv using your favorite web browser. From here, if you have an ERA Commons account or NSF credentials, you just simply select the appropriate icon and provide your login information. If you have an institution that is an in-common partner or would prefer to use Google, for example, you would click See More Third-Party Sign-In Options. The final selection is an NCBI icon where you can create a native account to log in directly to the site, which allows you to use the Forgot My Password feature. The second way to access your MyNCBI account in SciENcv is to go directly to pubmed.gov or any other NCBI page and click the login link located on the top right, which will provide similar creation and login options. After your account has been created, or at any time, you can link additional third-party accounts such as ORCiD, ERA Commons, HRA, which is the Health Research Alliance, and or NSF. You may also link your Google account or your institution if it's listed, which will provide you additional ways to access your single account. Linking is as simple as 123. To link your account, click on your username, which will be located on the top right of the screen. Locate the linked account field and click the change button. locate and select your institution or Google, and provide additional credentials. Another feature located in your account setting is delegations. As a researcher, you may not always have time to manage your account. My NCBI users can grant access to others to edit and create documents in ScienceCV, as well as add, edit, and delete citations in My Bibliography. Now it's time for a quick poll. I would like to know how you will be using the delegation within the MyNCBI account. Okay, it looks like the majority of you create and maintain it yourself. And it's equally split that you create and maintain it for someone else. This is a great option for you to use. To access this feature, again, you would just click your username located on the top right. You would add a delegate, type in the email address of the person managing your account, and click OK. The delegate will receive an email which invites them to create their own account in order to manage yours. Now that we have the administrative piece out of the way, let's begin creating a bio sketch. The first time you access ScienceCV, you will be taken to the Create a New Document page. The form will allow you to give the document a title, determine the format of the bio sketch, select your data source, decide if you will be starting with a blank document, duplicating an existing document, or using an external source like ORCiD. Now, remember, ORCiD will automatically import your biographical and citation data into the BioSketch. Finally, you're going to determine if you would like to share your document using a URL or keep it private. You always have the ability to change the setting at any time. Once you hit Create, you are ready to enter your information into the field. All BioSketches have the following components in common: the profile name or title that you created on the previous page, the profile type, either NIH, NIH Fellowship, IES, or NSF, the last time you updated the file, the ability to share, and over on the right, download options and OMB information. Please note, NSF documents, the BioSketch, and the current and pending support only have PDF and XML versions available, which is a requirement in NSF proposal and award policies and procedures guide. The next field is already entered with your information, which includes your name and any linked accounts such as ERA Commons, NSF, or ORCiD if available. Which brings us to the first section. Of education. Although the titles may appear different, in Section A for NSF, request the same data. Here you will enter your degree and training information. Once the information has been added, the summary will appear on the screen with the ability to delete or edit any entry. This is an example for NSF, but the education and training for NIH and IES BioSketches appear the same. So you're probably wondering, what happened to Section A for NIH and IES BioSketches? Here, it consists of a personal statement with the option to include four peer review publications. It's important to note that a lot of the information can be reused, but there are subtle differences between NIH and IES from the actual NSF BioSketches. Section B, request employment and appointment information, which are also similar. The NIH and IES request additional information. Always remember to read the directions provided beneath each section so you are providing exactly what is requested. Here's an example of Section B for NIH and IES. Here's the example of Section B for NSF. Section C is where you're able to provide a description in your own words your contributions to science and add supporting citations. You will notice in the box the ability to add a link to include the complete citation list of published works from My Bibliography, which will appear in your downloaded document for NIH BioSketches as well as IES. Section C for NSF BioSketches provides a description of acceptable and unacceptable products and citations to be included. There's also an additional unique element to NSF, which includes the ability to add additional citations. For Section C, all of the BioSketches have an add citation box that looks and operates the exact same. The first tab is My Bibliography. Beneath that, in the blue box, you will see add citations. Add citations will take you directly to PubMed in order to add citations to your My Bibliography. When you click on Go to My Bibliography, it will take you to, yes, you guessed it, My Bibliography. From here, you are able to, again, add your citations from PubMed, add citations from a file, which includes RAS from either examples or EndNote, as well as RefWorks, or add citations manually. Once that is complete, you're able to go back by clicking your username located on the top right and selecting Dashboard. You may have noticed that the dashboard looks a little bit different from the first time you saw it. Yes, you're able to customize the dashboard to either collapse, move, or hide windows. If you wish to restore any of the items, click the Customize page on this link and select the items to restore. Now, let's continue with the BioSketch by either clicking directly on the document or clicking the Manage ScienceDB link. Once we are actually back into the BioSketch itself, it will look like this once information is added into My Bibliography. If you have linked your ORCiD information, the second tab will populate as well. We would like to know how you currently use ORCiD. If you could take another brief poll with us, we would appreciate it. Okay, it looks like the majority of you do use ORCiD. For those of you who are not familiar with ORCiD, it's a nonprofit organization that provides a unique identifier that distinguishes you from other researchers. So you usually put this on your publications, but you can also use ORCiD in order to put patent products that you've created as well. Moving on. Section D for NIH and IES is where you are able to associate your awards and BioSketches. For the NIH Fellowship and BioSketch, awards and scholastic performances can be added, which is towards the bottom. For NSF users, you will use a completely different form, which is also part of ScienceDB, which is current and pending support. This is where you're going to add your awards as well as any in-kind contribution. Section D for NSF includes synergistic activities, which provides a box for free text. Once the information is entered, you have the ability to hover over the entry and change the position of the text, delete, and edit information. Once you have verified the information and are ready to save or print, the PDF links are available on the top and lower right-hand side, as well as the XML for all users. The only difference is, again, NSF users are not able to download the Word document. If you find that you have made an error, you can go back into this document, make the corrections, and resave or print. So in summary, ScienceDB allows you to create and store multiple documents from scratch, from data source such as ORCiD, and you're able to also copy your form from an existing BioSketch or CMPS form, which is NSF. You are able to output your PDFs or Word documents, depending on which one you're using, on demand. and you have delegates that you can manage your account. Documentations about SciENcv, My Bibliography, and My NCBI can be found here. Also at the bottom is an email address where we welcome feedback, suggestions, questions, and just general help if you are needed. Let's open the floor up to any additional questions.
Thanks, Sherry. Rana, are there any questions?
Yeah, actually, there are several. So Sherry, one of the participants in this particular webinar is really interested in using the BioSketch, but actually goes directly to funding sources, both at NIH and NSF. Is it possible through SciENcv to create separate BioSketches for NIH and NSF? And what if they're actually applying to two or three grant programs from either of these institutions? Can you use My Bibliography and SciENcv to create multiple BioSketches?
Well, within NSF, you're able to use the PDF, which they supply on their form, as well as the BioSketch within SciENcv. It's something that is going to be mandated by NSF beginning October 5th. The fact that you can interchange the information, because each policy, NSF as well as NIH, has their own particular guidelines, that's why there are slight differences, but at least we do give you the ability to share that information in order to create multiple BioSketches.
Excellent. A number of people are interested in ORCiD specifically, and they know that you can import ORCiD citations into My Bibliography to be used for SciENcv. Can you also do the inverse, take My Bibliography and reroute them back to ORCiD? Is there a better way to do it? Is one more effective than the other?
Actually, at this time, no. We just import their information. We are looking at other ways that they can also retrieve information from us in order to make it better for our users.
Okay, and as a follow-up on that, is there a direct pull from ORCiD into SciENcv? Is there the possibility to import or export BibTeX formats in My Bibliography? Do you happen to know about that?
Actually, we're looking at that way as well. If you would take your suggestions, all your suggestions, and write to info@ncbi.nlm.nih.gov, the more documentation that we have that this is what people want, the faster that we can probably get this into production.
Great. You may not know, but is there any particular place that provides advice for good quality BioSketches, what funders are looking for? I imagine that each funding agency might have its own documentation, but there are a number of people who have asked about guidance. What would you recommend in terms of them finding guidance about how to create a BioSketch for a particular agency or best practices and things like that?
I would definitely go back to each agency to ask your questions, because there are specific things that they're looking for.
Here's a question. If you have a current BioSketch and want to import your BioSketch into SciENcv, is that possible?
It is not possible at this time, but it is definitely something that I am taking note of and will put it in front of our development team.
And finally, in terms of exporting BioSketches, are there different formats for exporting? Like you finally created your BioSketch for NIH or for NSF, what formats does SciENcv export their BioSketches in?
Okay, so you have the ability to, for all of them, either PDF as well as an XML file. For IES as well as NIH BioSketches, you also have the additional Word document that you are able to manipulate.
Okay, great. Thank you very much for attending our webinar, and we hope you have a great and safe rest of the day. Thank you.
Thanks, Rana, and thanks, Sherry. This is Peter Cooper again. Thanks, everybody, and I'm going to go ahead and end the webinar.